One of the jobs of the U.S. Geological Survey is to assess the geology, seismology, resources of America. And they have a program in earthquakes where they construct the National Seismic Hazard Map. And it shows the central U.S., where we are, to be quite high. They have estimated the hazard to be what we consider to be much higher than it should be.
10 years ago, the Kentucky Geological Survey set out to challenge the high hazard risk for Western Kentucky because it impacts the state's economic future.
The federal government, by law, cannot build certain federal facilities within an active earthquake area of a certain magnitude. Between what is allowable under federal law and the competition between locating industries, these things have a big impact on your state's economy.
The region with the highest risk potential was the New Madrid Zone, which experienced devastating earthquakes in the 1800s.
In 1811, 1812, December, January, and February were three very large earthquakes. Once those earthquakes went off, pressure was released. And the amount of time it takes to build up pressure again, to have a failure like that, is in the order of hundreds of years, to perhaps on the northern limb of New Madrid, as much as 1,000 years.
KGS constructed the Kentucky Seismic and Strong Motion Network, made up of 24 stations across the state, to monitor earthquake activity.
Seismic hazard analysis has a number of components. The location of active zones, the maximum likely earthquake that can occur there, the frequency, how often those earthquakes occur on that zone, and then the way the rocks transmit the energy. All go into mathematical equations.
Doctors Cobb and Wang published their math based on the data from the network in 2012. What they found is the type of probabilistic modeling the USGS used to create the hazard map was incorrect.
What we find out, this method, mathematically, is not correct. That's what we find, this national hazard map is not scientific at all. That's why there's a problem.
So we do what's known as a deterministic modeling for, say, Paducah. And our results show a much more moderated seismic hazard. It's just not as big a hazard as, say, California and other places like Japan, China.
We show now clearly, scientifically, such high assessment for that area is not appropriate.